Today, we are going to focus on varying images. We're going to go over techniques for making updates and edits to an image, adding things, removing things, modifying it. We're going to go through basic variation tasks. The way that this is going to work is, I've got an image that Glimmer is going to send me. I'm going to pull that in, and then we're going to get common like variations that someone might want to see or might want to make to the image. And we're going to go through each of those inpainting tasks step by step. All right, so we've got this image. Typically, when I start working on an image, it's always good to kind of have a baseline prompt. When you're working on an image, you kind of want the commonalities of all the edits that you're going to be making. It's like photograph, right? We're doing like a photograph style. So I'll do a photograph, MySpace page from 1995. Why am I putting that in there? Just because, you know, it's fun. Glimmer, give me the first edit that we're going to make here, and we'll get started with modifying this. Removing the tree branch is my current task. So we've got this tree branch up here, and there's a couple ways that we could get rid of this. First way is we get a raster layer. We use the Alt hotkey to kind of pick some colors around this, and we just kind of like do some light painting out of it. Option number one, we paint over it. You know, for the ease of this, you know, right click the raster layer and copy that to an inpaint mask. That's like the easiest way to do it, because that way we know we got everything that is important there and that we've made changes to. You can also go in and obviously inpaint more directly. In this case, if we just were to do something like 0.4 denoising strength, it's not going to have enough denoising to actually change it from our chunky stuff. So it actually looks like it's not doing a terrible job here. It's a little bit out of place. It doesn't feel quite as good. So I'm gonna increase this a little bit to 0.65, and I think we'll find that we like it better. I am going to show you one more way we can get rid of that branch just for the sake of having exhaustive examples. So I'm going to delete or hide those raster layers that we did. Option two is we can erase the raster layer and let the AI kind of fill in the color. This will happen anytime there's transparency in an image. It's going to kind of guess the color and then run that denoising process. This will fill in the color for us automatically. That is based on this infill setting. So this is going to use a llama model to kind of guess this piece. But what it'll do is it'll fill that in, and then it will run the denoising process. So this is rather than us like manually going in and removing stuff or changing colors, it's literally just kind of like filling in the blanks. And as you can see, it kind of like did a big empty sky. And this is like one of the big differences when you care about what it is and what the shape of stuff is you want to kind of give it that guidance and that color. This is a good way to do it. Now you do want, when doing this technique of erasing, you want the regional kind of like colors around it to make sense. You want it to give it enough of the color that should be there so that it can kind of guess that. And if you need to, you can also go up a little bit on the denoising strength and generate something that is a little bit higher just so that it fits in. My next task is, what if you wanted this same man unchanged, but you wanted the background to be in the fall? What would you do? This has actually turned out pretty nice. I'm going to keep that one. So I want this to be in the fall. I'm going to merge the layers and select this object. It's going to pull this guy out, right? This one's an interesting one. I'm going to convert this to a raster layer, and I'm going to do multi-guidance detection, and I'm going to keep the strength pretty high, but I've got autumn here, and we're going to see if I can get the prompt to kind of push it into autumn while still using this kind of original image. So we got this autumn environment now, and our man turned into a bunch of leaves because we don't have him in the prompt. Poor guy, he's gone. Can see that we've kind of like changed the environment pretty significantly, right? Now what I'm going to do is we've got this cutout of a guy that we can just like add him back in, right? And we'll go in and do like some targeted inpainting. But now we've got like a little bit of a cleaner environment and we can start tweaking some of these things. You know, we'll come in and say, you know, a man sitting, but we'll do some in painting. And I think it'll come out okay. I think it's gonna be fine. Honestly, I think that like that task, it did a pretty good job. Some things I don't like is that it changed the color of the ground. So I'm gonna turn that on before I erase. So now we got like a nice area and we can go in and inpaint that and kind of fiddle with it. So that works too. Honestly, I think this is probably like the easiest trick to do relighting is just to use the multi-guidance detection. You can keep it pretty high. You can shift it down if you want to give more freedom to the color and the space. What if you wanted the same man, but you wanted to the background to be more of a jungle than a forest? So in that case, you know, we've got our man here and we can do the same prompt, a little bit less weight, and we'll say, and because we are kind of outpainting here, we're going to turn the denoising strength up pretty high. And what it is going to do is we still have our control layer here. This will bias it a little bit, but there's a lot of freedom that should come from this prompt. We've got a rainforest jungle here now. We've got a little bit of like deterioration on the edges, but I've got this cutout from before that I can bring up. And so now we've got that guy sitting and he's in a jungle now, right? And so he's kind of looking at that. Again, you know, if we come in and we want to like find parts where, you know, things should be tweaked a little bit, we can kind of like blend him in a little with these edges and just do that at a low denoising strength and we'll be happy. Now we've got this jungle scene. Add a white lotus style temple to the foreground mountain. Is this like why white lotus is in the hit television show? It's like a luxury temple. Luxury hotel temple vibe. Okay. Well, we're going to turn off our control layer for that. This time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in some stuff. Or maybe I'll just use this picture that Glimmer sent and try to make it more temple-like. So he sent in a picture. I'm going to paste it into the bounding box. First thing I'm going to do is maybe flip it, twist it, and reverse it. And then we're going to apply that transformation and begin to erase some of the stuff we don't need. And we are going to copy this raster layer to regional guidance. And when I copy it to a regional guidance layer, it is going to just take the area where there's an image and move that over to the mask. And so that's kind of what we've done here. And I'm going to say that this is a luxury high-end temple in Thailand. And then I'm going to copy this regional guidance to my inpaint mask. And voila, now I've got my inpainting. And we'll see what it hallucinates when I ask it for this temple. And we might need to turn that down. We're going to turn that to 0.4. It's not too bad. We're going to come in and detail it with a smaller one. Ooh, look at that. That's pretty cool. All right. We like that. We're taking it. We're going to come down and focus just on that region. And I'll hide our regional guidance here. I'm going to tweak this and take out our man, lush rainforest jungle. Then I'm going to select that and we'll do just a little bit more, just a little bit more. Overall, though, I think we've kind of like made some big changes to this. So I'm going to combine all of our raster layers into one new image. I'm going to delete all of our old ones out. I'll save this cutout of a man just in case I need him. Add a big snow-capped mountain peak in the distance. All right. In this case, we are going to add some color. And I'm going to do kind of like a dark gray. And I'm going to kind of like, you know, paint this mountain in the background. And I'm not, it's a little bit of transparency here. We're going to do some regional guidance. We're going to do a snow-capped mountain. And we are going to select that region right there. And turn this back on. We'll get rid of that control layer. And we're going to copy that to our Inpaint mask and make sure that we've got big snow-capped mountain peak in the distance. Nailed it. We changed it quite a bit, so it kind of did some cool stuff here with the clouds, I think. Yeah, kind of like blended in with the clouds and raised those hills up. So we like that. We're going to do some more Inpainting, though. And we'll do just one more pass of that snow-capped mountain, turn the denoising strength down to 0.6 or so, and just let it kind of reimagine those pieces on the top. Look at that, like meshed itself in with the clouds. The cloud is like coming over the top. It's blocking the sun, the lighting. Very cool. Super neat. We like that. Want to outpaint a bit or upscale? Let's outpaint. Let's do it. When you have empty space, as we've talked about in the past, what you're ending up doing is you're filling that in and then generating. The challenge is if you bring it out super far, it thinks it needs to make this prompt inside the bounding box. And so if you think about this, we see outside of the bounding box. You know, we see that there's a man in a temple over here, but the AI is focusing on this. And it's like, okay, I need to make a lush rainforest jungle, a big massive snow-capped mountain in the distance, and a luxury high-end temple. So if we outpaint here, we're going to get basically everything we asked for. It's extending it over to the right. We've got a bunch of mountains, and maybe we like it. We like the fact that the temple's been extended over here. This temple's kind of cool. We need to come in and do some inpainting. Like, that's one option. We can just like let it do that and be happy with it. Alternatively, if we want a little bit more focus and control, we can actually draw in what we want, and we can also change the prompt. So we could take out all of this stuff and just put a lush rainforest jungle Thailand. And what we'll see is that's going to kind of like blend out the image with just that prompt. That's really where you want to come in and tweak and poke and prod a little bit, describing what you want to extend with rather than just leaving the prompt the same every time you do it. We could do like a lush rainforest jungle next to the ocean. And then that's going to kind of like extend it out and make the ocean visible. Looks like maybe we're getting a little bit of ocean down right there. If we don't have a lot of context, it may not fit our original image that much. The more context we give it, the more it's going to kind of like gel with what we already had. In this case, you know, we might end up with something that is very, very different. So different, in fact, that it might have blurred too much on the left and it may not really fit. Yeah, so there's a little bit of shift in the clouds. Not bad by any means on its own because we've changed the prompt. It's actually pretty neat and cool, but we do then need to come back in and fix it, right? So we need to kind of come back and blend this point and just make sure that these two fit together. Glimmer, what's our last and final task for today? What do I have to do? Add a massive spaceship landing coming in from the water. I'm going to draw the spaceship. We're going to turn that into copy raster layer to regional guidance, and we'll say spaceship scraped metal empire sci-fi. We're going to inpaint the spaceship. Turn that up a little bit. I'm doing it full size right now rather than zooming the bounding box in because more than anything, what I want to get right now is just like a general composition. I'm trying to get like a rough shape that I can work with and then we can kind of detail it out more. Often help is if you have a picture of a spaceship and you kind of like jam it in. Got an artist in the audience that has some spaceship sketches. All right, he said, oh, hell yeah, that means we got to do it. All right, here we go. And we'll paste that into the canvas and we are going to convert that to a control layer. We're going to do contour detection. We're going to get the sketch out for the ship. Beautiful. Erase all of the other stuff other than that ship. Right? We're going to resize this control layer just a little bit. I'm going to turn isolated preview off because I want to get that position just right. Cool. And then what we're going to do is get back to our raster layer and we're going to tweak this raster layer a little bit. We're going to kind of fill in only where there's ship. We're going to get some color here. And then we're going to use our raster layer, a new raster layer, to create a new inpaint mask. And then we're gonna blur this. Okay, so it did that. Looks a little bit like, you know, janky. So I'm gonna try to figure out why. Probably because of the colors over here. Well, it's not bad. It's like close. It's getting closer. We're gonna turn up the strength, but I'm actually gonna keep this and then do our invoke one more time. What I can do is I could take this in painted spot and we can like take our ship and move it around if we want to. Now we'll have to like do some like object selection and stuff. But if we want to make this a little bit more controlled and not feel like it's like right in the middle of the screen, we can do that. I'm adding it as its own control layer, like the newly generated one. Apply that. And then I'll come in and we'll do just a little bit of in painting down here. Copy that to an inpaint mask and maybe just do a little touch up down here. Somebody said water disruption, water rippling underneath a spaceship. And what we'll do is we'll add a raster layer with some kind of this white surf over here. This one's got like some jet skis or something underneath. So maybe it's too much. We'll put that down a little bit more. It's more so made like rocks underneath it, but it looks kind of cool. Looks like that's like a parking spot. We'll leave it as is. Glimmer, this is the title for YouTube. This is how you create an image of a man on a hill looking at a temple near a lush rainforest with a spaceship floating on the ocean. Obviously very, very wide market we're going for with this specific task. We'll save that image out and we'll call it a day. Thanks again for joining, everybody. Hopefully you learned some cool tips and tricks and techniques as you kind of watch us play around with it. We'll see you next time. Take care, everybody.